cause I'm so used to this. Smoking at the pound, I'm so used. So I'm just gonna go ahead and jump into the video. My client has about, I would say, 4C hair. I have already shampooed his hair and blow dried it. I just want to show you guys the level of shrinkage here. So I'm about to go ahead and blow dry his hair. Really quick, I'm just gonna come back to show you guys that I'm using a dimming brush. You can get this from Sally's, and I'm using my Babyliss Pro blow dryer. You can get this from Ulta online. If y'all can't find it in the store, get it online. I'm about to go ahead and blow dry the rest of his hair off for camera so that the video is not too long, and then I'll be back. Okay, so we are back. A lot of you asked in my last video, why do I blow dry the hair? I blow dry the hair because natural hair shrinks as you're parting it. So if you want more clean parts and if you want your client to get the full length, then you're gonna blow dry it and then damp it as you go. So damp hair is shrinks less than soaking wet hair. So I'm gonna be using a spray bottle. I'm gonna mist it first. I'm going to be using my lock and twist. I'm going to be using my shine and jam. I'm going to be using my Nairobi foam, and I'm going to be using my parting comb. So I'm going to show you how all products go into effect. Okay, so the first step is to part. I kind of pre-part. So I just eye out the sizes. You can do whatever size you want. The smaller the parts, the more full it's gonna be. So once I see where I want the part, that's when I come in with my lock and twist. I use a little bit, less is more. And I just go over the part with the product. After I go over the part with the product, I'm gonna go over the comb to get all extra hairs out the way. And bam, you have a clean part. Comb the hair opposite ways, and then I did not mention you're gonna need clamps. I'm gonna clamp his free hair out the way. So on the root here, less is more. I use a little bit more lock and twist to smooth it down so that it's neat and it can last long. Comb that through, and then I'm going to go through with my shining jam. So I can see I'm gonna dip in my shining jam. And I'm going to apply a little bit past the root on all four sides. This just makes sure the hair stays sleek and neat. Then I'm gonna come through with my Mister Machine Mist. One spray, guys, one spray. And then I'm going to do one pump of Nairobi. And with that Nairobi, I'm going to comb through with my fingers and try not to get the Nairobi on the root, cause it's gonna, it's gonna make this start to frizz. So wipe off the extra Nairobi, and then you're going to split the hair into three. One, two, three. You're going to plait. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So I'm gonna stop at seven, and then I'm going to separate the middle one into the outer two, and then I'm going to twist, 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 all the way into the bottom. Do not twist tight, just twist loose. If you twist tight, it's not gonna spring up right. When you're done, it's gonna look like this, but as it's drying, it's gonna turn into this. So what I'm about to do is go ahead and do the next one. Hold down a little bit for me and turn a little bit to the left. Perfect. So y'all are gonna watch this one transform while I'm doing the next one. Same thing on this one. Same exact steps. If you need to see it again in the order that I used it in, then just reverse the video. I'm just gonna do this one again. And it is important to try to keep both of the strands the same size so that you can get an even twist all the way down. So I'm about to go ahead and do this row and come back. Now right here, I'm gonna explain what I'm doing here. So I started my next row so you guys can get an idea of how wide I do my rows. So when you're parting, I just randomly start a line in the middle of one braid so that when you're done, all of the braids can be, they can have a bricked effect, like they're in between one another instead of the braids being on top of each other. So when the braids are mirrored, it appears more full and more flat than if the braids were straight on top of each other. We are halfway through the left side. I just came to show you guys the progress here. If you follow those steps that I said earlier, yours should look like this, okay? So I'm about to go ahead and do this side off camera, and I'll probably be back to show you guys half, and then I'll be back to show you guys the whole thing. But right now, everything's neat, crispy, consistent, and I'm loving it. Okay, we are back with the finished product. Well, the almost finished product. So basically, when you're done, you're just going to go ahead and oil your client's scalp. I'm using anti-itch oil from Do Grow, and I'm just gonna go through his scalp really quick. Do not forget this part. You can use whatever oil you like. Another two oils that I like is tea tree oil or black castor oil, but I usually mix those two together and then put it on the hair because the black castor oil is too dense sometimes. So once you apply it on the scalp, just kind of like lightly massage it into there because you want everything to look moisturized and juicy. Do y'all see how beautiful that is? It looks so good, dude. And then he had a lot of tangled ends. So this is optional. I'm just gonna go through and clip off all of his extra ends that he does not need. So I'm gonna do that really quick. Okay, so the ends are gone. This pretty much completes the look. If you still have a little mousse like in the ends or whatever, you're just going to take your blow dryer and kind of just blow it off. And this is it. Parts are crisp. Twists are consistent. So let me know if this video was more helpful than the last one. If you did decide to do this on a client or on a friend or whatever, please tag me. Show me what you guys did. Let me know if it was helpful. And comment down below what videos you would like to see next. All right, bye.